A court has ruled one western Pennsylvania county must tell voters if their mail-in ballot was counted. And a Berks County woman has been found guilty of murdering her two children. Welcome to The Morning Agenda, WITF's daily news podcast, where the only agenda is you. A good morning to you. It is Wednesday, September 25th, and this is being recorded at 5:18 a.m. I'm your host, Tim Lambert, as we take this daily trip around the region's top stories together. A panel of judges is requiring a county to give voters a chance to fix problems with mail-in ballots and allow them to vote by provisional ballot if needed. My colleague Jeremy Long reports Republican-led Washington County violated state law when election workers refused to tell voters whether their mail-in ballot would be counted in April's primary.
In a 2-1 decision, the Commonwealth Court upheld a county judge's month-old order. County employees must now notify any voter whose mail-in ballot is rejected because of an error, such as a missing signature or missing handwritten date. And they must give the voter a chance to challenge the decision. Judge Michael Wojcik said the county's past policy emasculates the state's guarantee that voters can protest the rejection of their ballot and cast a provisional ballot.
Now, the suit was filed by a branch of the NAACP, the Center for Coalfield Justice, and seven voters whose ballots had been rejected in the April 23rd primary. They accused Washington County of violating the constitutional due process rights of voters by deliberately concealing whether their ballot had been counted. With a little more than 1 month to go before the November election, Kamala Harris's presidential campaign is working to get Republicans to vote for Democrats. My colleague Ben Wasserstein caught up with some GOP crossovers in Lancaster County.
Randy Roach from Philadelphia went to college with former Republican Representative Liz Cheney of Wyoming. He says the support she and her father, former Vice President Dick Cheney, have shown for Kamala Harris should sway support away from Donald Trump.
I'm not really sure how many people have to get up and say that the emperor has no clothes before large numbers of people begin to say, oh yeah, I guess he doesn't have any clothes on.
Now, Roach is a registered Republican and was among more than 100 people at the first in-person Republicans for Harris event in Pennsylvania. Speakers included former federal, state, and local Republican leaders such as Illinois Congressman Joe Walsh and Georgia Lieutenant Governor Jeff Duncan. Well, Pittsburgh has effectively banned rodeos for more than 3 decades, but a provision inserted in this year's state budget requires municipalities to allow such events. Tom Reese is with our friends at WESA in Pittsburgh and reports one Pittsburgh area lawmaker says she'll offer a bill to ensure cities have a say in whether or not to host rodeos.
Pittsburgh passed the ban in 1992 after a rodeo bull broke its leg and had to be put down. Local officials said the electric prods and other rodeo tools were cruel, but a last-minute provision in this year's state budget fiscal code overturned the ban, with no public discussion. Democratic State Senator Lindsey Williams represents the city. She says the provision took away the right of city residents to govern themselves.
So for 12 days a year, Pittsburgh would be required to allow rodeos to happen within the city limits.
All right, so PPG Paints Arena in Pittsburgh is already slated to host a Colorado-based bull riding company for 2 days in January. Williams wants to pass legislation that would rescind the state rule, but the Senate is controlled by Republicans, and it's not clear if a bill would even be put up for a vote this year. Now let's take a look at some of the headlines I came across when I went through about a dozen news sites across central Pennsylvania this morning. A Berks County woman is facing a life sentence for hanging her two children in the basement of their home in 2019. A judge has found Lisa Snyder guilty of 2 counts of first-degree murder, among other charges, and rejected the defense's attempt to claim Snyder was not guilty by reason of insanity. The Reading Eagle reports she murdered her 8-year-old son Connor and 4-year-old daughter Brinley by wrapping a dog lead around their necks and to a support beam. Lebanon County voters should get their mail-in ballots early next month. The Lebanon Daily News reports they'll send out more than 12,000 of them starting on October 1st. The county also plans to reestablish its mail-in drop-off site 6 days later. The county's Bureau of Voter Registration and Elections says more than 94,000 people have registered to vote in the November election in Lebanon County, and election leaders project turnout to be around 88% with both in-person and mail-in voting. And police are investigating a former Lancaster Country Day student for creating AI-generated nude images of female classmates. According to a search warrant, officers seized the ninth grade student's phone in August at an East Donegal Township home. Our sister newsroom, LNP Lancaster Online, reports law enforcement says retrieving the contents could help determine how the student generated the images and who the images were sent to. Now, as a reminder, The Morning Agenda is available anywhere you find your favorite podcast and on WITF's YouTube channel, which you can subscribe to. We are also on the NPR app. And be sure to check out our Spotify playlist. It's called The Morning Agenda Song of the Day, September 2024. And I update this playlist every morning with my, of course, Song of the Day. How about some yacht rock? I know it's past Labor Day, but nothing's wrong with a little yacht rock now and then. Steely Dan's Peg is my song of the day. And that's going to do it for The Morning Agenda. It's a daily news podcast from WITF where the only agenda is you. I'm your host, Tim Lambert. Thank you so much for listening today. Your company is always, always appreciated. Be well. Enjoy the rest of this Wednesday, hump day, and we'll talk again tomorrow.